Well, I've been running around this globe for a couple of spins now. Grown from school days to outcast from the in crowd. I keep my chin down as time flies and seasons vanish. Hold the self-belief to manage, grip and seize my canvas. Paint the color that connects with me and speaks my language. Try to release my baggage, be free to relieve the anguish. When it's freezing cold, feel the warmth between my toes. Up this earth I walk, creation is what feeds my soul. It can ease the load, climbing on the steepest road. So I preach this ode to remind myself to keep control. When it's all too much and I dive to free fall, I try to center myself at the center of life's seesaw. I crave the fun times, the sunshine entices. I want to root temptation and unwind my vices. From the drugs to the girls and the beers I'm drinking, and remember what's at stake, stepping in the mirror thinking.
Well, I've been down this road before. It's been one hell of a ride. The challenge is to balance on that fine line between the earth and sky. And I will wait for the morning sun till the way is clear as day. Well, okay, hallelujah. Now watch me take the stage. Oh, 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 oh.
Yeah. The hunt for the high, the people I've met, the places I've seen, the stories I've told, the folks in the road chasing my dream. On the brink, stop and think, I'm telling you dreams don't cost a thing. I know we all die alone, but I feel faith within that cosmic link. I surf the starlight where every wish is worthy. Only happy when you've got it, often makes you miss the journey. Coincide with chemistry, flow and ride my energy. We'll grow our grass greener than that other side will ever be. The man on the mic, the rose on my drum kit, happy with my reflection even though I've done dumb shit. And sometimes I think of stuff, keen to get that instant rush, fiending for that pick me up. That's probably why I drink too much. It's not the feeling of the high when you're running round, it's the friends that you find when you're coming down. From smooth sailing to foggy rocky roads, I won't be faked by my reflection like that dog that dropped his bone.
Coming here early was probably the best thing that we ever did. The Australian team has been in Europe for a long time, possibly too long. With my coach Wade Boots, we had a plan, taking the track basically one step at a time, just one cone to the next cone to the next cone and breaking it down. This race, I came into it, this final, I wanted to win. I said on my little notepad this morning, nothing but number one. This weekend, the Supercross World Championships is on as well, so I knew that my Rainbow World Championship stripes for the Supercross were disappearing this weekend, and I was here, so I wanted to win, and I wasn't gonna lose two titles in one weekend. There was three areas which I knew that I could potentially pass. I was really relaxed when Mariana had that little hole shot on me and that edge, and I basically just sat back and was able to read her. I knew where I could pass her. It was all on autopilot because I'd run over it in my head so many times. I wasn't close enough for the first two passes, and when we came into that bridge, I read her body position. I knew that she wasn't gonna hold that inside on the last corner. Generally, we'd never have a flat corner like that. It's very Supercross style, right up my alley, and I saw that position and that opportunity, and I went for it and put my all into it, and it really paid off. I held that inside on the last corner and did that Supercross flat turn, and basically came up, pulled beside her, and then won to the finish. I wanted to win this race at all costs, whatever it was, and I had those passing lines on this track that was so small that I knew they were either going to work or I was going to crash. But I was ready to take that gamble, and yeah, my poker chips were in, there was no safety net, and I was going for it, and it really paid off for that final. At the finish line this weekend, I was very emotional, and it's been a really long week and a challenging week, and the hardest thing about being a professional athlete at the end of the day is you have that racehorse mindset, but at the same time you're a human being, so when things go on in your personal life, it's hard to break up the two. And at the end of the day, I'm turning up to a World Cup, I'm Caroline Buchanan, I've got a race and I've got to perform no matter what's going on in my personal life. So today was a challenge, but I think to come into a World Cup event with so much going on, not having sleep and everything else, it just shows when you really want something, you can achieve it no matter how hard it is. Anytime anything goes wrong, you always step up to a new level and you always come out of it a stronger person. And even though it sucks in the moment, facing adversity and staring at it right in the face and overcome it, there's a lot of fear, but I'm never afraid to fail. So I always want to succeed and I'm ready to fall if I want to succeed. Next race is the World Championships, so very excited to go home and have this little press the reset button, see my family, see my friends, see my French Bulldog puppies and just switch off. It's been 5 weeks on the road, basically in Europe, and 7 weeks in total that I've been living out of a suitcase. So I'm ready to go home, unpack my bags and reset for that World Championships where I really want to win. It's been nice to have the rainbow stripes on my back this year and I don't want to let them go.